Fernandez. We are almost at the end of our novena. Tomorrow night we will celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit. So with humility we come to the presence of the Lord and recognize that we really need God's Spirit. And so with humility we ask also forgiveness for all our sins. And together we say, I confess, Lord my God, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done.
For as the heaven God, so great is his steadfast love towards those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far he removes our transgressions from us. The Lord has set his throne in heaven. The Lord has established his throne in heavens, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, O you whose angels, you mighty ones who do his bidding, obedient to his spoken word. The Lord has set his throne in heaven.
Peter had followed Jesus for
Now, before Jesus goes back to heaven, he says, follow me again, again, and again, and again. That's the whole idea that Jesus keeps calling us. Jesus keeps testing us. And then he tells us, you can follow me. You can follow me if you have the love of Saint Peter in your heart. Doesn't matter how many times you fail, but the last test, the most important, the graduating test, is very simple. Do you love me? So let us learn about, you know, our faith too. Sometimes we fail, but at least at the end, we can repeat with, like Saint Peter, yes, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. And then Jesus will keep telling us, then you follow me. With confidence in our God, who hears us, let us bring our needs before him.
For the Church, as the body of Christ here on earth, may the Lord grant us patience for one another, hearing with one another, in love, with humble and gentle hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world, national and local leaders, may the God who gives wisdom to the wise and knowledge to discerning and grant them just and prudent decision making, let us pray to the Lord. For all who are persecuted for their faith in Christ, may the hope of resurrection fill them with courage and strength, let us pray to the Lord. For all of us here, and who are following the Holy Mass through the live stream, may the grace of God embolden and strengthen us in our lives of discipleship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, marked with the sign of faith, may they come to share in the glory of the Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for Clarence and Florie Fernandez, for whom the Mass is offered. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for all our parishioners and all Christians around the world, that they will be in peace, receiving and preparing themselves to receive the Holy Spirit on Pentecost. And also we pray for all the people who are suffering with coronavirus, in the hospitals, in the senior homes, and homebound. The same time we pray that the Lord in his mercy will stop the spread of this virus. For this we pray to the Lord. Let us pray for our special petitions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Almighty and eternal God, hear our prayers and answer them according to your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, O God, of all creation, for goodness we have this bread to offer. Which earth is given into the hands and made the good become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, O God, of creation, for goodness we have this wine offered, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Father,
and all the rest of the sacrifices of your hands, for the praise of the Lord's name, for our good.
coming of the Holy Spirit cleanse our consciences. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift it up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, the beauty of salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for after his resurrection, he plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with passionate joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts with sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they are playing.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are the Holy Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray. Sending down the Spirit of our Lord, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, the supper was ended into the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith,
we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by taking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. We heard to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, his spouse, Blessed Apostles, and St. Catherine of Siena, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Lord and the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Saves the man for by the right teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
Lord, in thy name, thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Son, and the
Lord Jesus Christ, is of God. pardon our sins and in the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God, the Lord who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy to be mentioned in the name of my roof, but only say to the Lord, my soul shall be.
To receive you in my soul.
Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The Memorare. Remember, most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother, to thee do I come before thee, I stand sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the World Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy clemency, hear and answer me. Amen.
Glorify the Lord.